The first thing would be to ask yourself the question, is entrepreneurship right for me? Because running a business is very time consuming and it can often displace your usual list of priorities that you might have in life. It would mean less social time and a lot more time at home doing hard work. And sometimes you might not be in the right stage of your life to do so. So make sure that you're in a good situation financially and with your living situation in order to be able to start a business successfully. Understand what you want to do as a business. The world of startups is very, very glamorous, and a lot of people want to get into enterprise, but they're not really sure about what they want to do. The most important thing when taking that first step into understanding what you want to do is to find something that you're passionate about. All the hard work, all the dedication is a lot easier when you're enthusiastic about what you're doing, and then the hard work will seem a lot easier. At the core of all business is sales. A lot of very, very talented people from loads of different areas of enterprise and business go into starting up a company, but they will underappreciate the importance of selling their own product. A group of app developers can come in and create the best app in the world, but if they can't sell their product, it won't ever see the light of day. Make sure that all of your accounts are filed correctly. Make sure that you're on top of all your expenses. Businesses can go under because they can't afford to pay all their bills. So save money and look after all of your overheads. You find investment and cash to get your business off the ground. At the beginning, it's wise to bootstrap a business. Go on a shoestring budget for as long as you can. Try not to cut corners on important areas such as IT and a working environment. But when it comes to taking your business to the next level, there's only so much you can do on your own. And sometimes it's wise to go and seek a little bit of funding, whether it be from friends or family or from a bank or from crowdfunding organizations, to help your business really come to life. Not only can finance give you an option to hire loads of resources, but it will also give you flexibility in terms of time. So you can then delegate some of the more mundane tasks in your organization, and then you can spend time on doing more strategic and thought-provoking things that will drive your business forward. Understand what kind of infrastructure and processes you need to put in place. Find out if you need a good computer, find out about all the different processes that you'll need to record all of your customer information. If there's anything that's mandatory that's required in your business, make sure you try not to cut any corners and try to get the best that your business deserves. It's really important to save money, but not in areas where your business is vitally important. So if you're a web designer, you need to make sure that you've got a solid internet connection. And if you're a painter decorator, make sure that you've got a solid, reliable van to take to all your clients.